So in the previous classes we discussed about the tree representation, that we know the concept of the tree, that is the nonlinear data structure. So BST is the one of the important variation in the tree representation. As we discussed in the previous class about the order tree. Order tree in which the elements are arranged in some particular order, means whenever we insert a node within the tree, then that node is inserted and placed within the tree in based on some particular order. So binary search tree is the one of the example of the ordered binary tree. Here the binary search tree is represented like this, that in the binary search tree every node that you insert will be placed based on a certain order value. Here the order is decided based on the value of the root, means whenever you insert a new node within the tree, that new node is first compared with the root node. If the value of the newly inserted node is less than the root, then it will be inserted as a left child or within the left subtree. And if the node that you inserted is having the value greater or equals to the value of the root, then it will be inserted in the right subtree or as a right node of that tree. So this is the whole representation over here. So it will be like this. It is the root node. Here the value less than the root, here the value greater or equals to the root. So this is the complete representation, and same pattern is followed within the complete tree, within the subtree. At every level of the tree we follow the same pattern. So the whole representation is like this, and that's why we say it is a ordered binary search tree or the binary search tree over here. Let's for example, let's suppose we are having the node 39 as a root, let's say 25, 57, 12, 32, 76. Here you can see the example. In this you can say here it is the value of the root. Then here in the left subtree of the 39 we can find all the values which are less than the root, and the right subtree will find all the values which are greater than the root. And the same pattern is followed over here. If you take this part of the tree, so in this 25 is the working is the root of this subtree, and all the value less than the 25 is in the left subtree, all the value greater than 25 is in the right subtree. So within this complete subtree of the 39, at the left subtree that all the values are less than 39. So this is the complete representation. So that's why it is called the ordered tree. Now in this, if you find the in order representation of this tree, so we will find the sorted data. If you convert this thing, this tree, in the in order representation, so it will be 12, 25, 32, 39, 45, 57, and 76. So here you will get the data that we are getting is in the sorted order form. So whenever we form the in order representation of the binary search tree, we will get the sorted data. Now we can take the benefit over here that the binary search tree is most efficient way to search any element within the tree. If you have to find any element within the tree, then we start from the root. We compare the root. If the value that we are searching is less than the root, then we will follow the left subtree. Or if the value is greater than the root, then we will follow the right subtree. So at every level, our tree is divided into the half. Let's say that suppose I am searching for the value. Let's say we design the some more level within this tree. Let's say that 8, 20, 28, this is 35. Let's say these are some more levels over here. Now I am searching for the element 20. So I am looking for the 20. So I start from the root. I compare with the 20, with the 39. 20 is less than the 39, so I does not need to search in the right subtree. I will say that my data will be available only in the left subtree. So I will follow the elements in the left subtree. So all the elements in the right subtree are discarded over there. So my tree is divided into this half. then I compare 20 with the 25. As 20 is less than the 25, so again at this level, my tree is divided into the two part. Here, first I divided into the two part. Now here again, my tree is again divided into the two part. So my element will be available in the left part. Then I compare 20 with the 12. So it is greater than the 12, so it will be available in the right subtree of the 12. So again, my tree is divided into the two part. And then I compare with the 20. So that how many number of elements we compare? 1, 2, 3, and at last we got the element over here, it is a fourth. So the total number of comparison is reduced a lot in the binary search tree in compared to the other method. Let's say that for example, if you go with the unsorted array. So in the unsorted array, the searching of the element is quite time consuming. Here we may need to search all the elements within the array. And so here, how many elements we compare? Only the 4. So we can say that the complexity of this kind of the binary search tree is order of log n. But in the case of the unsorted array, if you had to search any element, then the complexity will be the order of n. N number of elements we need to search. If you compare this with the for the insertion and the deletion, so if you have to insert any element or the delete any element from the binary search tree, then it is quite efficient. Again, we need to search that element within the tree and we can perform the deletion. So again, the complexity will remain the same order of log n. But if we have to perform the insertion and the deletion in the unsorted array, then we need to search that element within the tree, within the array, and then we have to perform the deletion. So we may need to search all the elements for this. So complexity is very high. It is time-consuming approach. In the same way, if we talk about the linked list. So in the case of the linked list, if you have to perform the insertion and the deletion, so we can perform insertion and deletion quite easily. We can add anywhere. But if you have to search any element within the linked list, then again it is a time-consuming approach. So we can say that in compared to the arrays and the linked list, the binary search tree is quite efficient way to perform insertion, deletion and the searching. So this is our tree. Let's say that if you want to search any element, so how the searching is taking place. This is the algorithm to perform the searching. Let's say we form the tree over here. Again, we design the same tree, 39, 20, 48, 12, 25. Let's say suppose this is the tree and this is the algorithm over here. Let's say we want to search any element within the binary search tree, then how the searching will take place. Whenever we have to perform the searching, we every time we start from the root node. We compare with the root node. If our root is empty, means the tree is not present, so we can say that we will generate the appropriate message that the element is not present, or we will return the null value over there as the tree is absent. Or if we compare the element with the root and we will find the element at the root itself, so we will return the data. So the same we said that if the tree of the data is equal to value, we compare with the root node first. If it is equal to value, the value that we are searching, so we will return that 39. Otherwise, if the tree is null, no element is present, the root is absent, so we can say that we will return the tree, so at that time that value of the tree will be the null. Or if the data is present, so we will return the tree, then we will get the 39 node over here. Now let's say we are searching for the 22 in this. So in that case, as we will discuss, that we will compare the 22 with the 39. If it is less than the root, then we will follow the left. If it is greater than the root, then we will follow the right. So we compare value with the tree of data with the 39. As it is less than this, so again we call the same method in the recursive way and we call the tree of left as input. Now tree of left of 39 is 20. So now we call the same method. Initially we call it for the 39. Now we call it for the tree of left. Tree of left of 39 is 20. So now we call the same method for the 20 as an input root node. So now we start from here, calling the same method from here. So 20 is the input, we are looking for the 22, we call here. Again we say tree of data is equal to value, we compare 22 with the 20. If it is this there, so we return that. If it is not, so we'll say if it is empty. If it is not empty, then again we compare. If the value is less than tree of data, 22 is not less than this, so we'll search in the tree of fact. So we'll search in the tree of fact at the 25. Now we call the same method, search method, in the recursive way. For the tree of right is 25 is input and we are looking for the 22. So the same method is called as input 25 and the value we are looking is 22. Then we compare tree of data 22 with the 25. If it is there, so we return the value, but it is not equal to same, so this condition is false. We come to the else part. We compare if the value is less than tree of data, 22 is less than tree of data, then we call the search method for the tree of that, we call the search method for the tree of that, 22 here. So now our method is called for input 22 and the value is 22. We call over here. Now we call. So here we got if condition is not satisfied, the tree of data is 22, value is 22, the condition is met, so we will return the tree. So we will return this node that we have find the element within the tree. So this way we can perform the searching of the element within the tree. If the element is not present and the tree become empty, or we reach to the leaf node and the tree is empty, so at that time we will return the null value from the tree. So this is the way the searching is performed. So again, the searching is taken place the complexity order of log n. We does not need to search the complete tree, only some of the elements need to be get searched. This is the pre-order. If you have to traverse within the tree, then how the traversing will take place? If traversing is dead, we have to access each and every element of the tree once at a time, so that all the elements of the tree will get traversed. So here it is the pre-order. Pre-order means, as we discussed, that first we'll traverse the root, then left, then right. So same we said, first we'll print the root, then left, then the right. So the pre-order representation of this will be, first we will start from the root 39, root, then left. So take the left of 39, 20, again take the root 20, then the left of this 12, then 12 does not have any left, so 12 root is there, then left is over, left is not there, then the right, so 15. So for the 20, we have covered the left part, 20 is over, left part is over, then take the right. Take the 20, again start from the root, then left, then the right. So 25, then 22, then 20. Root, left, right. So for the 39, root is over, left part is over, then the right part. Again follow the same process from the root. 48 is root, then left. So 48, then 45. So this is the pre-order traversing of the binary search tree, that is root, left and the right. So this way we follow the same. Then next is the in-order. In-order is, in the in-order we follow the process that left, root and the right. So the same, we start from the root, then follow the left. Then follow the left. 12, we over here, then follow the left. So we does not have any left over here. So left, root, and the right. Left is absent, take the root, that is 12. Then right, 15. So the left part is over, follow the 20, then take the root, 20. Then take the right of the 25, 20. So that is come to the right. Again, we follow the same left, root, and the right. So left, 22. 25, 22, 25, 28. Root, left, root, and right. So now for the 39, left part is over, then take the root, 39, then take the right. So again for the left, root, and the right. So left is 45, and then 48. So here you will get all the data in the sorted order form, in the in order traversing. Then next one is the post order. In the post order, we follow left, right, and then the root. Left, right, and then the root. So we start from the root, then left, then left, then left. So it does not have any left. So left is over, then take the right, right, 15, then root, 12. Left, right, then the root. Then follow 20, left is over, then take the right. So again, here follow the same, 22, 28, left, right, root, 22, 28, 25. Now for the 20, left is over, right is over, then take the root, 20. Then for the 39, left is over, now take the right. So left, 45, left is over, right is absent, then take the root. So for the 39, left is over, right is over, then take the root, 39. So this is the post order traversing of the tree, that is left, right, and then the root. Now this next is that how we will perform the insertion within the binary search tree. Insertion is again almost same as the searching, that whenever we have to insert any data within the binary search tree, we start from the root. We compare with the root that the element that we are inserting is less than the root or greater than the root. If it is less than the root, then we will follow the left part of the binary search tree. If it is greater than the root, then we will follow the right subtree. So we have to insert the element in such a way that the property of the binary search tree is always satisfied. We cannot insert the element at any random location. We have to insert the element at proper location so that the property always remains satisfied with the binary search tree. So how we do that? We look for the element position, that at which position we have to insert the data. First we will find the position. With that position we will keep track of that which is the parent under which the element will get inserted. We keep track of the parent, we keep track of the position where we have to insert the data. Then once we got the position where we have to insert the data, once we got the parent, then who is the parent of that newly inserted node, then we will compare the node with the parent that it is less than the parent or greater than the parent. If it is less than the parent, then we will insert it at the left of the parent. If it is greater than the parent, then we will insert it at the right of the parent at that position. So this is the way we will perform this thing. So this is the algorithm for the performing the insertion. That is, the initial k given is the root as input and the value that we want to insert. First, create a node, allocate a memory to that node that you want to insert. So, with the help of the malloc function, we are identifying the total size that is occupied by that node and create a pointer to that memory location. PTR is a pointer that is pointing to that free memory location that we have created for that node. The data part we stored of that node, as we know that there are three parts within that, that is data, the left pointer, that is right pointer, pointer to the left subtree, pointer to the right subtree, and the data part. So the data part will store the value that we have to insert within that node. The left, initially the node is not at any location, so the left part is null, right part is null. So initially the node is created with these three values. Now if the tree is empty, let's say that we are inserting the first node within the tree. So at that time the tree is empty, so in that case we will insert the newly inserted node as a root of the node. So if the tree is null, tree is empty, so we will say that tree is equal to PTR. That newly created node that we created here will be work as a root of a node. So tree will be equal to PTR. Then we will assign the left part and the right part of the tree will be the null. Yes, it does not have any right subtree or the left subtree, so both will be null and that node is working as a. So we are having only single node. That is a single node within the tree. Now if we say that the tree is not empty, some node is already present over there. So now we have to find a position that at which location our newly inserted node will be there. So for that, as I told you, that we keep track of the parent also, that under which parent the newly inserted node will be there. So we have created two pointer over here. One is the parent pointer, which give take up the parent node, and the node pointer, which give take up the current node. So initially, the parent pointer is set as a null, and the node pointer is set to the tree. So means the node pointer is pointing at present to the root, and the parent pointer is null because the root does not have any parent. So that's why it is set to the null. So this is the current position of the parent pointer and the node pointer. Parent is null, node pointer is at the root. Now we keep on moving the node pointer up to the node pointer will become equal to null. So while the node pointer is not equal to null, we keep moving within the tree and find the position of the parent. So move the parent to the node pointer, node parent pointer which is initially null, move the parent pointer to the root node. The node pointer is still here. So at this moment the parent pointer and the node pointer, they are on the same position. Now move the node pointer based on the newly inserted value that we want to insert within the tree. If we are inserting the value less than the root, so we will move the node pointer to the left. If we are inserting a node pointer, if the value that we are inserting is greater than the root, so we will move the node pointer to the right of the tree. So if the value is less than node pointer data, let's say that for example we are inserting the value 24. We are inserting value 24. So initially we compare the 24 with the 39. As 24 is less than 39, so we will move the node pointer to the node on left. So we will move the node pointer which is initially on the 39, we will move to the left. Left is 39 to left 20. So node pointer is here, parent pointer is here. So 39 is parent of 20, so node pointer here, parent pointer here. Now for the next iteration, node PTR is not equal to null, so again we say parent PTR move to the node pointer. So now parent PTR which is now 39, on the 39 will move to the 20. So now here node PTR is here, parent PTR is here. Again we compare 24 with the 20. So if the value is less than node PTR of data, 24 is less than 20, condition is false. So it come out here, this condition becomes the true. So now node PTR will move to the right. So as the 24 is greater than 20, so now the node PTR move over here. 24 is now node PTR is here, 25, parent PTR is on the 20. Now 24 is again compared with the 25. It is less than the 25, so now the node PTR come over here on 22. Parent PTR move to the 25. Now 24 is again compared with the 22. As the 24 is greater than 22, so move the node PTR to the right. So now the node PTR becomes the null. If the right of the 22 is null, so node PTR is now null, and the parent PTR moves to the 22. So we have found the position of the parent. Who is the parent of the 24? Parent PTR is 22, node PTR is at the null. So this loop will get over, and we have found the position of the parent PTR. As a 22, node PTR is null. Now we compare 24 with the parent PTR. Then if the 24 is less than the parent PTR or greater than the parent PTR. If it is less than the parent PTR, then 24 will be inserted at the left. If it is greater than the parent PTR, it will be inserted at the right. So we compare value with the parent PTR data. If it is less than, so parent PTR the left pin will insert PTR, newly inserted node, or will insert at right. So the 24 will be added right up front. So this way we can perform the insertion of the data within the binary search tree. Next, we are going to discuss about the deletion in a binary system. To discuss about the deletion, whenever we perform the deletion from the binary search tree, we have to remember that the property of the binary search tree should always be the satisfied. So there are three cases here for the deletion. The first case is that the node that we are deleting is a the first condition is that the node that we are deleting is the leaf node. Let's say for example that 15, 22, 28, 45, these are the leaf node. And if we are deleting this node, so this node can be deleted directly without affecting anything. Let's say for example that if I want to delete the node 28, then the 28 node can be deleted directly because it does not have any child further. So it can be deleted directly. So this is the first case that if we are deleting a node which is a leaf node, then that node can be deleted directly. Okay. Second case is that the node that we are deleting have one child. The first case was that in which it is a leaf node and does not have any child. Second case is that the node that we are deleting is having the one child. One child either is the left child or the right child. Let's say for example, let's suppose we are deleting a node 48, which is the internal nodes, and it is having the one child at a 45. So when we delete the 48 from here, as the 45 is the left child over here, so in that case, this after deleting the 48, the 45 which is at present a left child of the 48 will become a right child of the 39. Because 48 is initially a right child of the 39, so by deleting the 48, the 45 will come over here. So 48 will be replaced by the 45. So if you are deleting a node, if you are deleting a right node, and if it is having a child at the left, then that child will become the right child of its parent. So 45 will become the right child of the 39. And take the previous case. Now take the case. Let's suppose I am deleting a node 12, which is a left child of the 20, and 15 is there with the right child of the 12. So when we perform the deletion of the 12, so as the 12 is a left child of the 20, so after deletion of the 12, the 15 will become a left child of the 20. So 15 will be removed from here, and in place of 12, we will get 15. Is the 12 was the left child, so 15 will become the left child of the 20, even if the 15 was the right child of the 12. So this arrangement will be there. So this was the second case, and the third case is that the node that we are deleting have two child. So this is the third case. Let's for example that 25. If you want to delete 25, the 25 is having the two child, 22 and 28. Or let's say if I want to delete 20, so 20 is having the two child, 12 and 25. So again we are deleting the internal nodes. So in that case, what we have to do? In that case, the other two possibilities are there. Either we have to find in order. Predecessor or in order successor. In order predecessor or the in order successor. Now in order predecessor will be a largest node in the left subtree. In order predecessor is a largest in left subtree. And in order successor will be the smallest in right subtree. So let's say if I am deleting 20, so I will look for either the in order predecessor or in order successor. In order predecessor is the largest in the left subtree. So left subtree of the 20 is this one. So largest is 15. Or in order successor of the 20 in the right subtree. So So 20 is the right subtree, this one. So we will look for the smallest in the right subtree. So smallest is 22. So this 20 will be replaced by either 15 or 22. And after that, the respective deletion will be taken place. So we are converting the case 3 in the case 1 or case 2. Then if we replace 20 either if the by the 15, so 20 will be replaced by the 15 and we will delete the 15 from here. So the case 1 will be there. If we replace 20 by the 22, so as the 22 is the leaf node, so again the case 1 will be there, 22 will be deleted from here and 20 is replaced by the 22. So this way we can perform the deletion of a third case, that node which is similar to child will be replaced by either the in order predecessor or in order successor. This is the algorithm for the deletion. So initially we will test that whether the tree is null. If the tree is null, then we can say that the node is not present within the tree and we cannot perform the deletion of that node. Then we compare the value with the tree of the data. If the value that we are deleting is less than the tree of the data, if the tree of data is initially the root node, if the value that we are deleting is less than the root node, so we will follow the left. Means, let's say if I have to delete a 25, then I compare 25 with the 39. It is less than the 39. So I will call the same method again. Now the 20 will be the input. So I will call tree of left for the 39 is 20. So for the same method is called for the 20 as input and the data that we are deleting is 25. That will be the tree of left. Otherwise, let's say if I have deleted the 45, so in that case 45 is compared with the 39. It is greater than this, so I will call the tree of right. So I will call with the tree of right is 48. So I will call the same method again with the 48 as input and the value that we are deleting. So this is the recursive way. So we keep on traversing within the tree up to we find a data that we want to delete. If the data is not present, then the algorithm is terminated. But if the data is present, so we keep on moving either in the left or in the right up to we find that particular data within the tree, that particular location within the tree. Right? So this part is over. So now here we say that we have found the data within the tree. We reach at that particular node where the data is available that we want to delete. Now come here. Now here we will look for all the three cases. That if the data that we are deleting is having two child. So if the tree of left is not null and the tree of right is not null, means it is saying left and right both the childs are there. Let's say for example 25. If we want to delete 25, we reach at the 25 by this approach. Now we will say that tree of left is not empty, tree of right is not empty. So in that case, we will find, as I told you, that there are two ways are there. Either we find the largest in the left or we find the smallest in the right. So we have taken here, we find the largest in the tree of left. So we find the largest 22 in the tree of left. Take the pointer PTR on that. So PTR is pointing over here and the tree is pointing over here. Now we replace the tree of data 25 by the PTR of data. So 25 is replaced by the 22. So here we will get on place of 25, we will get 22. So tree of data is replaced by the PTR of data. Then we call the same method delete for the tree of left. As now 25 is replaced by the 22. We deleted the data. Now we have to delete this 22 from the tree. So we call the same method again for the tree of left. Tree of left of this is 22. We call for this and delete this node from the tree. Right? So this way we perform the deletion for the third case. So this is the okay. Now let's say that the node that we are deleting is not in the third case, but it can be either in first or second case. So let's come over here. We come to the S part. Now take the PTR on that tree, the node that we want to delete, we reach over there, we take one more pointer, PTR over there. Now if we say that the node that we are deleting is the least node. It does not have any left, it does not have any right. Left is null, right is null. Means, let's say we want to delete 22. As in the previous case we have said that we replace 25 by the 22 now. And now, then we will delete the 22. So 22 is the leaf node. It does not have any left, it does not have any right. In that case, we will set the tree as null. We delete that node and then free BTR. That data will be deleted. That node will be deleted. Right? This is the first case. That deletion first case. Now the second case. That the node that we are deleting is having either left or right, but single child there. So if the tree of left is not null, means it is having a left child. In that case, we replace the dead node with its left. The tree will be replaced by its tree of left. So whatever the node is are present in the left object, that will be replaced at that node. So let's say for example that if I delete the 12 from here, so whatever things are available at the right, then 12 will be replaced by this. So 12 is replaced by the 15. And then we delete this thing. So we replace or we replace with this, with the right. So this way we can perform the deletion from the tree. Now second is how we calculate the height of a binary tree. Height is depth, the level, the depth of a tree. So if you want to find a height of a binary search tree, so they can be calculated by calculating the height of the left subtree, height of the right subtree, and in the left and the right subtree, whichever the height is larger, we'll add the one in that. So let's say that if the height of the left subtree in this case, height of the left subtree in this case 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. For the 39, the height of the left subtree is 3. Height of the right subtree is 2. So for the left we are adding 3. For the right we are adding 2. And we add the 1 in the higher one. So 3 plus 1 will get 4. So height of the tree is here, in this case, is 4. So again, this method is the recursive way. So initially, we call the method for 39 as a root node. If the tree is null, no node is present, so we will say we will return the 0. No height is there, the 0 will be written. Otherwise, we can calculate the height of the left subtree, we calculate the height of the right subtree. So, as we call this method for the 39, let's take a simple example over here. Let's take this simple example. Now we call the method for the left. So for the 39 we go at the left and again call the same method in the recursive way for the 20 now. For the 20, again the tree is not null, it comes to the S part. We calculate the height of the left. Height of the left. What is the left? It is null. So, it calls the method again here. Now the tree is null. We call the method for the tree of left. For the 20, the left of the 20, we call the method. It is saying tree of null. So it returns 0 from here. From the left. 0 is returned. Now for the 20, the left part is over. Now call the tree of right. So we call for the 25. Now same method is called again for the 25. For the 25, we call tree of left. We call the method, the same method again for the tree of left. What is the tree of left of the 25? Is null. So we say tree of null is 0. So it will return 0 from here to the 25. Tree of left. We call for the 25, left is over. Now call the right. Right is right part, it is null. So we call the same method again. For the right part of the 25, it will return as that it is null, so it will return 0 from here. So 0 is written over here. So left and right are over for the 25. We compare the condition, this condition is false. It comes over here, right height plus 1. Right height we are getting is 0 plus 1. So it will return 25. So 25 will return 1 from here to the 20. So for the 20, we call when the tree of left, we get the 0. When we call for the tree of right, we get the 1. So for the 20, both parties over. Now come here. Left height is greater than right height. Condition is false. It come over here. Return right height plus 1. We are getting right height is 1 plus 1. So 20 will return 2 from here to the 39. So for the 39, as we call for the tree of left is over for the 39, and we got the value in the left height is 2. Then call the tree of right for the 39, means for the 48. Again the same method is called. For the 48, again we call tree of left. So we'll get 0 from here, tree of left height. Call the tree of right for the 48, we get the 0 from here. Again, based on this condition, 48 will return 1 from here to 39. So 1 is written over here. Now, for the 39, left is over, right is over, both are there. Now this condition is tested. Left height is greater than right height. The condition is true. So it will return left height plus 1. So left height is 2 plus 1. You will get the value 3 is the result. So this way we can calculate the height of a tree. Next is that we have to calculate the total number of nodes in the parallel system. How many number of nodes are there, including the internal and the external? So total number of nodes is calculated by the number of nodes in the left subtree, number of nodes in the right subtree plus 1. So by that, plus 1 is for the value of a root. So for the root is there, then number of nodes in the left, number of nodes in the right plus 1. So here by this, you will get the total is 4. The number of nodes in the left subtree is 2, number of nodes in the right subtree is 1 plus 1, plus 1 for the root. So the total we are getting is 4 here. So this is the recursive method again. We call the method for the 39 as a root node. The tree is, this condition is false. It come here in this part. It call for the left, it call for the right. It call for the left first. So for the 39 left, it is called for the 20. The same method is again called for the 20 as input. Now for the 20, again it come to the S part. It call for the tree of left. Left of the 20, it call for the left of the 20. So it will return, it come over here. Again the same method is called, it come over here, tree is null. So here, from here we will get the 0 as a tree of left for the 20. Now for the 20, we call tree of right. So it call for the 25. The same method is again called for the 25. Now for the 25, again we call tree of left, tree of right. So for the tree of left, the 25, it return 0. So from left, we'll get 0. From right, we'll get 0. Left is 0, right is 0. So the 25 will return, left is over, right is over, plus 1. So it will return, 25 will return 1 to the 20. So for the 20, we cover, left is over, right is over. So here we got the 0, here we got the 1. So the 20 will return 2 from here to the 39. Now for the 39, the left part is over. Take the right part. For the 48, again the same method is called. For the 48, take the left, take the right. So from the left, we will get 0. From the right, we will get 0. So 48 will return 1 from here to the 39. So for the 39, we get the left as a 2, the right as a 1 plus 1. So total we are getting is 4. Here is the result. So this is the recursive way to implement the thing. So that's all for today.